NYK sustainability efforts have produced a breakthrough. The tugboat Sakigake is the world's first ammonia-powered vessel in commercial use.
LNG can decrease emission of the carbon dioxide compared with the heavy fuel oil, 25% more or less. But ammonia, 95% decrease can be achieved.
According to Bloomberg NEF, ships powered by LNG and other alternative fuels make up nearly 40% of the global shipping order book. The industry is working in partnership with governments to scale up its decarbonization efforts.
Investment in alternative marine fuels have soared extraordinarily. We have seen strategic corporate initiatives multiply by almost 28-fold, and also venture capital and private equity investors have poured in around $2.2 billion just in the past 4 years alone. The large shipbuilding nations like China, South Korea, and Japan are setting up national programs to support the transition.
This is funded by the NEDO, so-called the Japanese agency. And also the NEDO has the kind of the GI funds and the green innovation funds. And also the Japanese government is supporting the usage of the ammonia as the pyrogenic fuel.
It's more expensive than normal standard fuels.
Yes, it is. And at this moment, and the supply of the ammonia volume is very much limited compared with the LNG and also the heavy fuel oil. But in order to promote ammonia as a marine fuel, together with the other industry players, and we can have the kind of the mass production, then the cost will be decreased. The next year, we expect to have the large-sized ammonia carrier powered by the ammonia. And this is also supported by the GI fund. Then the next 10 years, we try to increase the number of the vessels powered by the ammonia.